So the Blue Jays got the result they wanted in the series opener yesterday. Heidi, how would you assess this team's attitude entering today's contest?
Well, Matt, this club got off on the right foot with a big win in game one of the seven-game series. But there was no self-congratulations going on in the clubhouse before this game two matchup. These guys feel like they need to approach every game like it's a decisive game. And as one player told me, winning yesterday doesn't do anything for us today. So it sounds like this team is pretty locked in on the task at hand, guys.
Now at the plate, Miles Straw. He went down on strikes last time up. He's set. Here it comes. This is on the outside corner for strike one. No runs, three hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. And he lays off for ball one.
Well, these guys haven't had too many opportunities yet to test the running game in this one, so they could decide to put a man in motion right here.
That's back toward the mound. This will be a tough turn, however, to second for one. But one's all they were ever going to get, and the inning will continue.
No real chance from the roll two that time. He's just too quick coming out of the batter's box. You basically have to make a perfect turn on a hard-hit ball to double him up. Now they need to keep an eye on him over at first.
So it's a runner at first with two men out, and that'll bring up Yordan Alvarez. Drops in a strike to start the at-bat. Nothing one.
This is what fires me up right here. You don't get a chance to see this every day of the week. You got the reigning Cy Young Award winner squaring off against the reigning MVP. That's why you pay the price of admission.
Strong is off of first with two away. One and two. From the belt, kicks and deals. Early swing there as he pulls it foul to the right side. Tried to shoot the corner and he missed it. Two and two.
I know he missed with a fastball right there, but this guy's arsenal, you can't figure out what he's trying to do. He's got a lot of different directions he can go in right here.
2-2 is a changeup that misses. 3-2.
Good running count right here. Three balls, two strikes, two outs, runner on first. He'll be off to the races on this pitch.
Sent on the ground out to second. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. Astros lead one. They're down 1-0. And that'll bring Anthony Rizzo to the plate. He'll get his side started in the inning. And Dan, so far, they've been stifled offensively since the first inning.
Boy, they sure have that. They came out of the gates and got hot right away. But whatever was going for them pretty much just disappeared. We'll see if they can wake it back up.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. The wind up and the 0-1. Pulled toward right center field. And he will make the catch while ranging backward as he just put the glove up and hauled it in for the first down.
Now batting, third baseman, Vladimir Guerrero Jr.
Next, it'll be Vladimir Guerrero Jr. It was a backwards K, a strikeout looking for him in his last at-bat.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system. Especially now, he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
Ready. Here's the first pitch.
Hey, that's just a great mix of pitches right there, and that's what this guy's going to do if he's going to keep this team off balance.
Hit hard, but foul.
There's another pitch for a strike, and this guy's really attacking hitters well tonight, being aggressive early on. And if he continues to throw strikes like he is, he's going to have a pretty good night.
Line drive to center field, and that's in for his second hit of the afternoon.
Dan, right here you see a situation where no doubles defense can come back to bite you. As a pitcher, are you even aware when guys are playing a foot off the track?
I'll be honest with you, Hero. You're so concerned about the mound trying to get that white ball to that dark brown black glove that I never really ever turned around to even notice where they were playing. I was concerned about getting the guy out swinging the bat.
So that'll bring in Teoscar Hernandez. No balls in one strike. Set with the 0-1. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact. Can't keep the weight back, and he falls behind 1-2. Trying to send him packing for the second time. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And he just couldn't keep that ball fair as it winds up a long foul ball.
Ah, man, just a hair early on that one and just pulled it foul. He's going to have to find a way to refocus. Not easy to continue an AB after you just went deep foul.
Runners on first with one down. And a breaking ball runs in and gets him. And I doubt there was any intent behind that.
Yeah, I can hear the crowd murmuring now, wondering if he hit him on purpose. But hey, us pitchers need to be able to throw inside, especially when facing hitters as dangerous as he is. Pretty sure this one just got away from him, and hey, that's part of the game.
So it's a tight spot here. First and second, one man out, and that brings in George Springer. Look, now the pitch.
Well, the Blue Jays have been searching for that big hit pretty much all game. They're hoping they get it right now. This would sure be a good time.
Easy take there on the sinker, well off the outside. One run, five hits, and no errors in the game for Toronto. Ball two with a sinker that runs off the inside.
Has to be a challenge pitch coming up here. He probably doesn't want to flirt with loading the bases.
Breaking ball. That's in the dirt as he takes a ball.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
And a full count to George Springer. It's 3-2.
Not a spot you expect a curveball. He's lucky he missed because that's the kind of pitch that gets hit out of the ballpark.
He's set. Here's the 3-2. And this is on the ground to short. Could be two. The second for one. Relay to first in time. And just like that, this side is retired. Blue Jays held in check, but they hold a 1-0 lead. First-rounder Alex Bregman. And guys, seventh inning already? Hey, I'm not complaining, but this one's been flying by.
Yeah, I'll agree with that, Matt. That's what you get when both starting pitchers have it working. Neither of them have been nibbling around the strike zone at all, and they've trusted their defense to make the plays, and they've done just that.
Yeah, and it's resulted in a game that could really go either way in these late innings. Now, 2-0 home. Hard hit ball to second. And that's through into right, so a leadoff single here to start the seventh.
Now back, the shortstop, Carlos.
Here's Carlos Correa now, as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. No hits to this point. Two as the fastball is let go.
Let's see if he tries to climb the ladder right here, change his eye level, or bounce something in the dirt.
job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive.
Hey, he's been able to pound that zone all night, working that outer half of the plate. That's why he's having so much success.
And now he'll foul this one off as well to fall behind here. No balls and two strikes. Now this is slowly hit to short, probably too slowly to get two. And indeed, he won't look at second. He'll just flip it on over to first to take the sure out.
Now back. Second base.
Next up for the Stros, Jose Altuve trying here to plate the tying run from second. From the stretch, here's the pitch. As the first pitch here's a bit high, it's ball one. And he'll try to check his swing here, but he'll have no such luck. It's strike one. Bregman leads off second with one gone in the inning. Fouled off.
Lucky he got a piece right there. He was definitely late on that pitch after seeing a previous off-speed pitch.
Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away.
Classic slider down and away from a strike out there. Not a whole lot to say about that pitch that hasn't been said a million times already. That's just a real tough pitch for a hitter to pick up out of a pitcher's hand, so they end up chasing when they're in protect mode.
Rizzo is there, and will step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. One left for Houston. It remains 1-0. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and standing in the outfielder, Lourdes Gurriel.
Lourdes Gurriel.
First pitch on the way. This is driven to right, and no doubt about it, that one's way out of here. A solo shot here to straightaway right field as the Blue Jays take a 2-0 advantage.
You don't see this very often over this starting pitcher. This guy's not used to giving up some bombs, so I'm sure that'll be a wake-up call, and he'll start throwing some better pitches.
Kevin Biggio stepping up now. And he fouls this one off. 0-2 for him to this point. Behind 0-2 now. Bases are empty here. Nobody out. High and deep down the left field line. And it's a foul ball. Now the pitch. Fouled away. Two once more. Swung on, and he went fishing in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Biggio is retired, and there's one away. Next to dig in, Marcus Semien. 0-2 from him so far in this one. Now the pitch. High in the air out to center field. Strong is back, and he'll get there to make the play for route number two.
Now back, the catcher, Joey Bart.
Next to hit, Joey Bart singled in his last at bat. Here's the first pitch.
Ball one, no strike.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Hit hard on the ground to third. On to the first baseman, Gurriel, and that will end the inning. Jays add one more on the solo home run. Seven complete here tonight. It's now 2-0 Toronto. It's been a long time coming. Haters gonna be part-time loving. Now to the plate, Kyle Tucker. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Always a tall task trying to rally back in the late innings, but I think this game could still turn quickly. A leadoff runner on base right here could be huge to get something going.
And a strike to even the count. 1-1. Just behind the fastball there, two strikes now.
Even though we're late into this ball game, this guy's velo is still top-notch. This guy's a horse.
Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball. Time to be alert for signs of tiring here in the eighth. He's a pitch away from 100.
Man, I love this right now. He's given it everything he has, giving this team depth, allowing the manager to pick some serious matchups when it comes to going to the bullpen. Dan,
Paul, you nailed that, D-Row. Now you can go to your go-to guys, the troubleshooters, the guy you want to bring into close games. Anytime a starter can get you through seven innings, the eighth inning, it's a bonus. A job well done so far.
Corey Lee digging in now. This will take a look at a slider here that finds the zone for strike one. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Outside for a ball, 1-1.
Well, he's thrown a lot of pitches in this one, but it's not like he's walking a bunch of guys. Only one free pass to this point, but they're still making him work really hard.
Here's strike two as the slider hits the outside corner.
Well, he's done a real nice job of that breaking ball in this start. That's not the first time he's locked the guy up with it.
Changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for the ball. Now a swing and a fly ball. On the run is Hernandez, but this will land untouched.
Well, somebody's sitting off speed right here. Only way he was late on that heater is he was expecting another changeup.
On the ground to third. Scooped up. Throw in to the first for out number two. Back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Michael Brantley. Only four outs remaining for them to try and rally back in this one as he takes a fastball off the plate for a ball, 1-0. Two out, nobody on. A ball and a strike to Houston's leadoff batter.
Hey, I still believe in my heart the best pitch is a well-executed fastball down the way, and that's exactly what that is. He swings at that. That's off the end of the bat. That's not hard contact at all, and that's an easy out for the defense.
Hit on the ground is short. Bichette gathers it in. Over to first, and that retires the side. 1-2-3 go the Astros. They trail things here 2-0. Ryan Abreu is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 66.
So the lineup flips over and digging in, Bo Bichette. He was retired after popping out in his last at bat. First pitch on the way. A big roundhouse curveball in there for strike one.
You know, some guys just don't like pulling the trigger in a 0-0 count. They don't like the ambush tactic. They like to calibrate the speed, maybe pick up the brake. They want to know everything your ball does before they pull the trigger.
Count now a ball and a strike. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2.
You never want to take the aggression away from a ball player, but in this situation, I'd like to see the leadoff guy try and work the count a little bit more, especially when his pitcher's missing like he is.
The 2-2.
Full count.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Well, this is hit high and deep out to left. And this one is gone, a home run. So a solo shot down the line in left, and the Jays have moved out in front 3-0.
The one thing with this homer, it might make the decision to send the starter back out there a little easier for the manager. We've got some wiggle room now, and he's been pitching well, so I expect they'll be having that conversation in the dugout. You know he wants to go back out there.
Anthony Rizzo stands in now.
Anthony.
As he would look at the first pitch fastball for ball one. He could really use a knock here, 0-3 in the game so far. Wind up. Here comes the 1-0. Good zip on that one as he just throws it by him for strike one.
If you're on the mound right here, you got to trust your catcher and execute. You know who's coming up to the plate.
And this will be fouled away. That misses, and we're even at 2-2.
He might have to look for a different way to put this guy away on 2-2. He's already seen the curveball a couple of times, so he might be looking for it.
And he lays off a pitch off the plate and high, 3-2.
Well, you don't see it all that often, but this might be a good time for a 3-2 change. If he can locate it, it's nearly impossible to hit.
Lifted down the line and left. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. The 3-2 pitch is swung on and driven out to right center field. A ball that's well hit. Strong will back up and put this away for a long out number one.
Now batting, third baseman,
next to bat for Toronto, Vladimir Guerrero Jr. It was a base hit last time up. And now the first pitch. Fastball misses inside. It's even at one. Might have another one as this is hit high and deep out to left. And it's gone as they add still another. A solo shot here to left, his second home run of the game, as the Blue Jays have opened it up further down, 4-0. Long ball is playing in this one. That was the fourth blast of the game so far for this lineup. Dan Dero, what are your thoughts on what they're doing as a team so far?
Yeah, Dan, this doesn't make sense. It's absolutely freezing outside. The last place you want to be is in a batter's box. And this offensive team is driving balls out of the yard.
This is what's crazy about the game of baseball, Dero. You would think under these conditions, it would be all in favor of the pitchers. That has been anything but the case so far in this one.
Ryan Stanek answers the call now, looking to get this one onto the ninth inning without any trouble. And it's fouled away. He's 0-2 in the ballgame so far. Line to second, where it's caught there for out number two.
It's really important to be a second baseman and have some athletic ability. How about this right here? He goes up high to snag this line drive that was definitely headed to the outfield for a base hit.
George Springer the next to hit. And on the first pitch, he grounds foul. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. off the plate. One ball, one strike. Maybe too much break on the slider. 2-1. And a fastball, but he's losing it a bit here to 3-1 now. Lourdes Gurriel would be next. The 3-1 pitch. Fouled off. Now the payoff pitch home is a wave and a miss. He struck him out. So two runs come across here, both coming via the solo home run. Game two heads to. So now here is Miles Straw. He's the one to start off the ninth inning with his guys in danger of going down two games to none if they can't rally. Too high that time with the inning's first pitch. It's ball one.
Hey, I hope that call doesn't throw him off his game right here. He's been pitching one heck of a game, and I'd hate to see the umpire get in his head right now.
Astros center fielder ahead with a 2-0 count. Into the windup and the pitch. Swing and a line drive. And that'll make him 1-for-4 in this one. That'll bring up Yordan Alvarez. And he'll watch one miss up and away for a ball, 1-0.
These are the moments in the game that can sway it one way or another, why you get a W or a loss right here. Leadoff man on, part of the order coming up. Guy out on the mound, this guy's work cut out for him.
Into the corner and slicing foul. Strong gets his lead at first, nobody out. And he misses again, ball three.
Every ball club has that spark plug guy, and this is the guy right here. He usually ignites a lot of productive innings.
And misses. So a single and a walk, and it's first and second with nobody out. And that'll bring up Alex Bregman. And these guys are making a little push here. You have to like the effort despite the odds.
Yeah, you really do, Matt. Look, they still have a significant hill to climb, but hey, they string a couple of hits together here, and all of a sudden this thing feels doable.
So now the Jays manager will make his way out toward the mound, and a change is forthcoming as that's going to do it for his starter here this evening. So he'll leave after eight strong innings as he couldn't quite make it a complete game, but he's in line for the victory nonetheless. Jordan Bamano takes the ball now in inning number nine, looking to close the door.
Number 58.
Now the pitch.
Hey guys, that fastball just registered 97 miles an hour. On a night like tonight where it's super cold out, if you don't get the head to that baseball right there and you get jammed, it's almost like getting stung by a pack of wasps.
Behind 0-2 now. Nothing in two count and the pitch. This one's flared out toward left. Oh, what happened? He can't make the play. Since risking anything here as the bases will be loaded now with still nobody out.
Boy, Giro, we're looking at a big inning right here with that single. Bases are loaded, yet no runs have scored in this inning.
Yeah, and that's exactly what that pitcher wants you to see. You have to eliminate the noise, Dan. Just try and drive in the guy from third base. Don't put pressure on yourself that you have to get everyone in with one swing of the bat. Pass the baton and keep the line moving.
No hits in three tries so far. He struck out once. Now the 0-1. And he fouls this one off. Bases loaded here. Nobody out. Breaking ball below the zone. That's ball one. The 1-2 is a wave and a miss. He struck him out. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, man, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone to protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
So up to the plate next will be Jose Altuve, as he'll look at a fastball too high for ball one. Strike this time to make it one ball and one strike. Bases are loaded here, one man out. 1-2 as he chases the slider.
Boy, I love the way he's competing out there on the mound right now. He's got a chance to rack back-to-back K's with two runners in scoring position. He's not giving in at all.
So 1-2. Popped him up. Rizzo in foul ground. Play, and there are two gone now.
The first baseman, number 10, in the FBI, going down.
Now the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel, and he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth. First pitch on its way, as he'll try to hold back on the swing, but he went around for the first strike. Hit back up the middle. Bichette picks it up cleanly. Throw on to first is going to be in time, and the Blue Jays have held serve here at home. They take games one and two of this series as this one is over. So the Blue Jays have grabbed a commanding 2-0 lead in this best-of-seven series, guys.
Yeah, Matt, let me share an interesting stat. A team that jumps out to a 2-0 lead in a seven-game series, they win that series about 83% of the time.
That's super interesting right there, Dan. And that's all well and good, but the way I look at it, only 50% of the work is done right now. They've still got to win two more games against a very good team who is now going to be fighting out of a corner. You can never get comfortable in postseason baseball.